Okay, it's time to judge. So we'll start with the starter from Dan, please. I think we're getting a prawn kebab. With a spicy marinade rub sauce. I don't know.
It's going to be chilli because it's Dan.
Yeah. And as it's Dan, we knew it was going to be beautiful. That looks fantastic. That looks what have lovely. We got?
We have got a marinated prawn with the same as the marinade, but sort of a sauce turned into a sauce on the bottom, smeared. And just some fresh coriander to finish it off. Yeah.
Happy?
Enjoy. Yeah, really happy. I think it looks really good.
Certainly
and,
does look
hopefully
good.
It tastes
great.
Good.
No, that's terrible. I think you've definitely learned from the spicy from the first round, and that's.
Yeah.
There
should be a bit of a sweet note to it, really. There's a bit of sweetness in there, should be, and then it should come in with a bit of warmth afterwards, hopefully.
That's really nicely balanced, actually. Mm-hmm. That lovely
fantastic.
Warmth in the back.
And the fresh coriander, mm-hmm. just to finish off, perfect.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah,
no,
just have to try again, just
yeah,
to make
this
sure.
Is just my third check, because sometimes one of them is okay and the other...
You've got another 10 checks there, don't worry, it's all right.
That's yeah. delicious.
Mm-hmm. Well fantastic, thank you very much.
Excellent.
Cheers.
Well done.
Thank you. Still looks right.
Coriander just finished off really nicely as well.
And our next starter, Alan, if you could bring over your starter, please. Look at this. This is
wow.
presentation.
Lovely. Yeah.
Wonderful. Now it's decorated with an orange. Remind us what you've done.
Because it's orange because the prawns have been marinated in orange and gin.
Not that marinade. No. Well, I can smell the gin though.
Oh yeah.
And then were they on the barbecue for?
Just a few minutes.
And have these been smoked or grilled or?
They were grilled.
Oh yum. That's a very subtle flavour. Mm. But the gin and the orange is really good on the fish. Really
it's
good.
It's orange marmalade and the zest of orange.
Mm.
Yeah. But the orange flavour is really delicate, it's coming through nicely. And there's a back note of gin there as well, which is really good.
Try getting some fresh orange juice on it, see if that just zings it up. Yep.
Yeah.
Still delicious.
Mm. Yeah, definitely getting the gin coming through. I've just done a gin tour recently down at Plymouth Gin and did all sorts of different tasting of gin and stuff. And nice gin as well, you can feel the flavour of gin coming through with that.
Mm. Superb, well done.
Lovely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And our last starter, Andrew, if you could bring up your starter, please. We're getting away from fish now, and I think we've got a pork burger, haven't we?
We have. The Bulgarian theme.
Yeah.
Ooh, that looks excellent.
So, tell us what you've done.
So, we've got Bulgarian burgers, or Kofte in Bulgarian, char grilled little gem sweethearts, and then a Bulgarian rustic salad, which is tomatoes, garlic, and toasted granary bread, a little bit of olive oil.
So that is bread. I thought
that's
it
bread.
Like bread.
Yeah.
How do you recommend we do it? Should we be combining them all?
I think a little bit of burger, a little bit
Right.
Egg sandwich.
I'm going in. Happy with how it went?
Yeah, very. Very. It's fun to have a burger on the barbie.
Yeah, you can't. We were hoping, weren't we, that we'd get at least one burger in the Great British BBQ Off. You can't not have burger.
That I've provided it.
I'm going for the full forkful.
Mmm. Mmm.
I'm not sure I'm nasty enough, but I'm gonna try.
I love the salad. The pork's got a really lovely complex flavour. What is there, cumin in there? Or?
Cumin, good shout, good spot. Cumin, lemon zest, lemon juice, a little bit of chilli flake, onion, parsley.
I've never char-grilled lettuce before.
Yeah, will you again?
Delicious.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, I was a bit sceptical about that, to be honest.
It changes it completely. Mm.
But I think the star of the show here is definitely the kofta. That's really good.
Excellent.
Thank you. Well done.
Lovely, thank you. really nicely combined. Mm.
Okay, time to judge the main course. We'll start with Dan, please.
Ribs.
What am I missing?
Yeah,
do
I need them with the ribs?
Do I never need them? Oh, no, I don't need cutlery, it's ribs.
Depends what else we've got.
Wow. Fantastic. What have we got?
We have smoked sweet corn, banana wrapped in bacon. Mm-hmm. We've got a crunchy potato salad with sort of so like a fresh herby potato salad. Mm-hmm. And then we've got some smoked ribs with my own spicy barbecue sauce.
Great. Do you want to carve us some ribs?
Yeah, you can. Yeah, I'll cut.
That is a lot of sauce. I have to tell you, that is a lot of sauce.
Are you worried about the amount of sauce?
Yes.
Do you want a fork?
About there.
Fish
bones.
Okay. On the fingers and just hit a bit in there.
Yeah, and these go angled. I think you're angling that way slightly.
Should we get the experts here?
Yeah. Do you want to? I mean, they should just. Tear off if you want to use your fingers, it's up to you.
Do you want me to cut some up?
Yeah, do the one.
While you carve.
Probably not the best knife for it.
That one's got my name in it, I think.
Banana overboard. Right. Should do us for
really tender.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good. Hopefully not too spicy. It's got a kick to it.
I'm going to say, for my taste, that is too much sauce. I'm going to take
fine.
Some off.
You never know. Some people want a lot of sauce, some people don't.
Well, it was a thin end as well, so there's less meat to sauce, as it were. That's so tender.
Mm. The meat's still got a nice bite to it as well, which I like on a rib.
We are getting a bite and the meat staying on the bone.
Mm. That's what I like to see.
I did try down that end, but I'm going to try up this end because it seems like it's a different experience.
Yeah, that's the more meatier bits as you move in.
It is spicy. Mm. But I like spicy too, so I'm happy with that bit.
Yeah.
I can tell it is.
It is a spicy barbecue sauce. That is, I mean.
Actually, I'm not a big spice eater, but that is fine for me.
Yeah, I tried to go something a little bit different with ribs because I think sometimes you tend to go and they're all fairly similar. So I thought a spicy barbecue sauce would maybe bring a different element to it.
I'm impressed with the amount of meat on this rib as well.
Mm.
Yeah, it was a great rack. Of this. Great rack of ribs.
Mm. Great rack.
Yeah, nice one, man.
That's
try
so
the other bits, I suppose.
Mm.
Yeah, let's cut one of these into half.
Mm. This is what I'm really looking forward to taste.
I'm scared of this.
Oh, I'm not.
Bacon, banana, cinnamon.
Someone's got a whole one, someone's got and the other to share half each.
Can I have that small bit? Because I'm nervous about it.
Okay.
Again,
I don't mind.
Go large.
No, I'm still going to cut it in half.
Wow.
Oh, lost it.
Mm-hmm. My brain doesn't know what's going on, but it's good. It's good. Really good.
I quite like it as a side. It's something a little bit different.
It's awesome.
Mm. Delicious.
I love it.
Mm. Cool.
I absolutely love it.
But my head can't take it. Bacon, cinnamon, banana. But yum. And the bacon's got a bit of crunch on it. Oh, it's delicious. Weird, but delicious.
Yeah.
Token vegetable.
Oh, we've got to try the Iranian, because they were brined, weren't they? Just
yeah, frequently. Yeah. That's I was saying earlier, it's like an Iranian street food. They brine the sweet corn and then grill it over some coals. And that's and my dad loves it and introduced it to me. And that's how I like it, with a smoky finish to it as well.
Oh,
your potatoes are lovely.
Mm.
Really
they've
lovely.
Been on the grill as well.
Yeah, no, they were boiled. And then what I've done is I've actually like fried them off a little bit to give them a crisp to it, because just another texture on the plate, I think, is something that's important.
I don't know if the camera's picking up, but there is just that slight crispiness. This is so good.
Mm. I hope the freshness helps.
Coriander
yeah.
is lovely.
Mm. Potato salad has never been like that. That's amazing.
Never
thank
putting chives on a potato salad again.
Yeah.
and the corn.
So there is a bit of char on the corn, it's got colour.
It says smoke, so it should a smokiness, there should be a little bit salty. Hopefully, that's come through for you guys.
Actually, that's
lovely.
Mm, yeah. Really nice. Mm.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm glad you like it. To corn, as I know it, I think.
Yeah. That's such really nice. An abundance of different flavours going on there.
And you only have to brine the corn for like an hour. It doesn't take long because it doesn't need much. Yes, it can be too overpowering the salt, but hopefully it's not. Hopefully it's just there.
Well, you've got the sweetness of the corn balanced by the slight saltiness, which is perfect.
Fantastic.
It's really good.
Mm. I'm crying. It's not emotion. It's chilly. My nose is running. I'm a mess, but I'm happy. Yeah. I'm happy.
Tears
well
of
done.
Joy.
I just want to eat that last banana.
Do it.
Go on.
I'm going to have a bit more potato. Go on, have that bit of banana.
Go on, then.
Don't eat all the ribs when you take it back.
I need the banana.
Wow.
Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you.
Really good, thank you.
Cheers.
And our second main is Andrew's. If you could bring it up, please, Andrew. And this, we're going from ribs to fish.
Mm. How unusual, fish.
Mm. You surprise us.
Fish is one of your favourites,
it
I think.
It is, yeah.
No, I've never eaten cooked radish.
Yeah.
Wow.
It looks interesting.
Just have one by itself in a minute. Mm,
okay. So, what have we got here?
So, we've got a fillet of salmon, mm-hmm. which is a skinless fillet of salmon. So, it's a bit more interesting to cook because the skin often holds it together.
Yeah.
It's been marinated in some ginger and some lime powder, salt and pepper. And then we've got char-grilled broccoli and radishes, little rye flour chapati. And then we've got, this is a Turkish coffee barbecue dipping sauce.
Fantastic.
So and would you recommend that we dip the salmon into the sauce?
Well, I've popped some on the top.
You have.
For you in case it's slightly less elegant with just your fork. But yeah, I would definitely have some with it.
Okay.
For sure.
Thank you.
Okay.
Radish.
I know.
That's delicious. Mm. You're not afraid of a char, are you?
No.
No, when you say charred, that's a char.
Yeah. Mm. I don't actually like radish, but I like that.
Doesn't taste like a radish,
nice.
Does it?
No, it doesn't, does
it's
it?
It's weird.
No. Don't know what it tastes like.
No, I can't tell you what that tastes like.
You can do it with baby turnips as well. Yeah. Exactly the same with baby turnips.
Let's have a look at this fish. That is beautifully cooked.
Broccoli is divine.
Really? Grilled broccoli is a favourite of mine.
I've never had it.
I've never had it either, so.
Ah. Oh, no, I am going to need a knife. So you've definitely been brave on the cooking of that.
It's
you can't overcook it.
The ginger's coming through, but it's a real delicate flavour of ginger,
just
which
a bit
is
of
lovely.
Warm. It balances with the cardamom as well.
Mm. That's very complex. I'm getting the lime, that cardamom. There's a sweetness.
Bit of honey.
Bit of honey. Mm. Mm. Wow. I'm just going to check. That I enjoyed that as much as I thought I did. That's a really, really complex bit of fish cookery. Well done.
Thank you. Yeah, that's great. The sauce is really nice as well. Just dipping that into the sauce.
This is the coffee sauce.
This is the coffee sauce, yeah.
Turkish coffee, wasn't it?
Turkish coffee.
I love Turkish coffee.
Oh, it's lovely. I was worried about the rye.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's heavy. Rye flour is just heavy, but that's lovely.
But that's your carb, it's the only carb on the plate.
Mm. Yeah. Wow.
Well done.
Superb.
Thank you very much.
Lovely. Good barbecuing, well done. Happy.
Sorry. Nice to see something different with lots of different elements as well.
Yeah.
And that broccoli was quite charred.
Yeah.
It was almost popping in your mouth. Which is
quite
nice.
It had crunch, it has it, but it really tastes good. I thought it was going to taste burnt. It doesn't at all.
No.
Should we move straight on?
Yeah.
Okay, and our last main course is Alan's. If you could bring it up, please, Alan. I spy a finger bowl.
Or lemon soup.
Alan is a considerate man. He's a gentleman to the last.
Oh wow,
there's
a fish.
Wow.
Finger bowl. Oh. And napkins.
Yes, get down the cutlery. Beautiful. Yeah. What have we got, Alan?
Pork ribs. potato planks and sorted vegetables roasted in a bag, an aluminium bag.
Oil. Fantastic. Tell us about the way you treat the ribs and the flavourings you put in.
Okay. The base was the dry rub. It was a 14 spice dry rub, mm-hmm. but I didn't put too much on it. Perhaps I think I could have gone a bit further with that. And the base is just a fairly simple blend of spices, cider vinegar,
right,
brown sugar.
And you've decided to serve yours dry as opposed to saucy?
Yes.
And that's your preference on ribs?
Yes.
Excellent.
I'm just going to see what happens if I tear it off, and it tears very easily.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I might start eating then.
Okay.
I'm going to cut one off as well.
Yeah.
As soon as you cut them for me, I'll just save myself a job.
I had to take some off the front because it was too big for the board.
I can really see where the...
the smoke,
the rub and the smoke has
turns it
permeated into the meat. More of a bite, but it's still beautifully tender. It's actually really meaty, isn't it? Because you've treated it more gently.
Yeah.
So the flavour of the pork, and this is really good pork, is really coming through.
This is more about the meat as well. Yeah. This is more about the flavour of the pork, which is good, and then there's that backdrop of spice, which is nice.
Yeah.
Nice just having a little crust on the outside as well.
Mm. And it's coming away from the bone clean as well, which is what you want.
I prefer it not to fall off the bone, but come away clean and easy.
Yeah, we're leaving a bite mark again, so we're happy with that.
Delicious. Oh, hang on.
Oh, the soup.
Lemon there.
Yeah. I don't recommend the soup.
Let's try these planked potatoes.
Yeah, that's an easy way, isn't it?
There is. I'm with you.
Very nice.
Simple.
What have you put on these?
There's mixed herbs, salt, and pepper. Black pepper.
I'm going in with the veg. What was in there?
There's onions, tomato, courgette, a little bit of broccoli, corn that I cut off the cob this morning. Did I say mushrooms?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And that's it.
A bit of red pepper.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, is that garlic?
And garlic too.
Yes. I might not eat that whole garlic actually, if you don't mind.
Or the one next to it.
Really nice actually, and it's really soft and tender. Mm.
I'm really, really pleased to see that, you know, barbecue allows for everything, doesn't it? Mm. You can go really heavy with loads of spices and heavy saucing and glazing and everything, and that's delicious.
Yeah.
But you can also treat, you know, with a bit more of a view to bring out the flavours of what you're cooking, which is what you've done here with all of them.
Mm.
Very, very good.
Yeah.
And the fact you started with such a good piece of meat in the beginning, is let the meat shine through, which is great.
Yeah, it was lovely meat.
Thank you.
You don't need that one.
No. It's a spare. It's a spare rib.
Get out of here. Go.
Okay.
The puns are meant to come from us, not you. Nice work. Okay, so it's time to judge desserts. We'll start with Dan. If you could bring your dessert up, please. Apple cake. And I'm expecting to see, remember, he promised us a fanned apple design on the top.
Okay.
So I'll be interested
brown sugar
to see.
Crust.
Hopefully that water spillage on top didn't do any damage. Who's there?
Oh, nice. Right. Come in, Luke. Don't go anywhere. What have we got?
This is a, it's like a heart, it's more, probably more of a winter dish, but we're getting there. It's a bit like a hearty apple cake, really. Cinnamon and apple, with a maple glaze, and that's it really.
That looks beautiful, but you live in Devon, don't you?
I do indeed.
And that's the amount of clotted cream you're giving us. Go get more. Go on.
Do you want more?
Yes.
There is more left over. All right.
I think
it's been pilfered. I see. Okay.
The other contestants, no marks for the cream.
There'll be no marks of the cream. This is purely so that it can be enjoyed.
I clotted that cream last night.
That's funny. It looks remarkably like a famous Cornish branding.
Hello.
Are we there?
That's more like it. Right.
Glenn's piece.
Can you secure it?
I've got it.
Oh, you've come thank off well.
You. Okay. Do you want to have a go?
Thank you for the help there.
Oh.
Oh, and I'm left with it.
I think you're in an apple.
Yeah.
Mm. Now, there is a lot of cinnamon in that.
Mm.
But it's brilliant.
Mm.
I can taste the apple beautifully. I looked at the colour of that and I thought, is there tons of cinnamon? Did you use brown sugar?
It's brown sugar as well, yeah.
Right, so that explains the colour.
Brown, dark, soft sugar. So that's where it gets the sort of brown sponge from.
It's lovely because it's not too sweet.
No.
There's a really lovely balance to it, and there's a lovely crunch still from the sugar and the glaze at the top and the apple as well.
Fantastic.
That's really nice.
That might be my... replace my pineapple upside down cake is my favourite, I think.
Did either of you get any sort of caramelisation on top of the apple?
Definitely. Mm-hmm. I'll have the crumbs then, shall I?
There's a whole cake there.
Didn't want to deprive you.
To take that?
Might be hot. No,
sorry. Asbestos. Yeah.
Delicious. Really well done.
Oh, fantastic, guys. Perfect. Thank you very much.
That bit's mine for later.
Yeah.
All right.
Don't eat all that.
I'll save you.
Lovely. Thank you.
Good work.
Thank you very much.
Take Roger his cream back as well.
Thank you, guys.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Excellent. Mm. Ready?
Ready.
Okay. Let's have Alan, please. If you could bring your dessert up. Pecan pie.
Mm.
Salvaged.
Yeah.
Well done.
Not a bird nut inside.
No.
Cream.
Hello. There we go. This is Phoenix pudding.
risen from the ashes
of the pecans.
So what did you do to your nuts?
I took my eye off the ball really, and a few minutes too late to rescue them.
And yet we have a pecan dessert. That's fantastic.
I had reserved some for decoration, which I've done there.
So is there a layer of pastry inside the ramekin.
Yes, yeah.
And then the filling is?
It's syrup, sugar, pecans, and butter.
Do you know what it looks like? It's got tons of nuts in it, which is great. I thought that, you know, you were going to be really struggling, but this doesn't look in any way lacking.
No.
Did you have any worries about doing it this way? This wasn't the original version?
No, this wasn't planned at all. It was going to be an 8-inch pie dish. Turn out as I've frequently done before, but
pastries, right?
I don't know. The bit I just had was possibly a bit undercooked, but
the filling is lovely.
Yeah.
Again, it's not overly sweet.
No, it's not. Considering how much sugar
and
syrup has gone in. Yeah.
But it's quite difficult to eat, as you can see.
Yeah.
It's actually very nice.
It is, and the pastry is cooked. It's a bit hard to get to, but that was
unfortunate. Yeah.
You would have had a non-stick.
Mm. Oh yeah.
Cake
pattern or it was just a glass
dish
that was a pie dish that was would have been.
Mm. Well, I tell you what, irrespective of the fact that it was a Phoenix salvage job, delicious.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Well
really
done.
Good.
Yeah, thank you.
Right.
Mm. Well recovered.
Thank you very much.
I'm not a lover of pecans, but that was great.
That was nice.
Mm.
And pecan pie can sometimes be really sweet, as in sickly sweet.
Mm.
So that was nice.
I just wanted to get a spoon to delve into that, really.
If you had a big glob of syrup on the corner of yours, I thought, ooh.
Yeah. Be right back.
I'm almost sad to say, judges, that this is the last judging of the Great British BBQ of 2015.
I'll never eat again.
Andrew, can you bring up your dessert, please? Oh, any worries we may have had are replaced by the fact that it's huge.
And so is the cake.
Wow. Okay.
Dust off the
stunning.
That's not dust, that's cinnamon powder for effect.
That was decoration. Right, what do we got?
We have an apple and cinnamon cake with finest clotted cream.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
We need a knife.
Yeah.
Shall I go and get one?
Yes, please.
Do you mind?
Not at all.
Wow, I'm it's going to just going to have a look because I'm wondering if that's a good colour. I guess this is going to be one of the challenges about baking in a barbecue, that you're going to get, it's all about bottom heat, isn't it? Right.
Me?
You.
Me, you, to me, to you, to me, mashed potato.
Cut the cake. What texture are you expecting on the bottom?
I'm expecting it's going to be slightly firmer on the bottom.
Crunchy or is...
Yeah, a little bit of crunch. But we should be quite soft in the middle, which I think we're looking at.
Lighter coloured than the other cake we had. Is mm-hmm. that a lot of cinnamon in it?
No, because I think cinnamon as a spice is very overpowering. Mm. It's too much of it.
Just cut that side as well.
Thank you.
And then you can have that bit.
Cheers.
So what did I do to offend you that I get that? Really?
Now it looks like I'm just mauling it.
Brash, you are. Brash,
brash. Right, I'm going in.
I'm going to go for the cream on the fork and then I'm going in.
A bit warm on the bottom.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I'm going to eat it and see how much it, you know. That.
Actually, it's just not what I thought.
It's not upsetting me as much as I thought it would.
No.
It's not a crispy burnt base. Mm-hmm.
It doesn't actually taste burnt. That's really weird. It's
potentially caramelised with the sugar in it and the heat from the bottom.
I know, but you look at that and you just think that's going to be completely ruining bitter, and it's not.
It's not at all.
That's weird.
It's actually
weird.
Still spongy.
Oh.
It was quite protected by the tin. You made it indirect by putting the water pan in, didn't you?
No.
Did you have water in the water pan, or was it dry?
Very tiny amount, just a tiny amount.
I think that's probably what saved you.
Yeah, because you wouldn't have it directly over those coals anyway.
No,
because it's just.
And how low down, how high up did you cook? Halfway.
Halfway. So
top
good.
Next time, I think.
Yeah.
Nice light sponge.
Mm.
But it's a very even, very even colour on the bottom.
Yeah. Consistently black.
I think I would have liked more apple,
if
I'm honest.
Yeah, I did look at it afterwards and think another layer of apple. Double the layer of apple.
But attractive, delicious. Well done.
Yeah, really nice presented. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that was the judging.
Let's go and talk about
final
this.
Deliberations.
Do we not get to eat anything else now?
Till next time.
Better go and score.
Yeah. Cool.
Really pleased with everything, to be honest. Really pleased with everything. Everything came off exactly how I wanted it. So if the judges score me and they didn't like it, then that's fine, because I was happy with everything. So, and I think they enjoyed it all when I served it to them. The starter came off lovely, really good flavours. Sweet, spicy, and the freshness from the coriander, I think it's a really great combination. My main, I felt, was again a really good course. My ribs came out exactly how I wanted them. My spicy barbecue sauce, I'm fond of, so hopefully everyone else was. And all the sides, I felt came off really well as well. They all added to the dish. Again, little taste of this, little taste of that, loads of different textures on the plate, so hopefully they enjoyed that. And my dessert, I've cooked it before. Came out as it should. To be honest, this last challenge for me has just gone perfect for me, and I don't want to sound arrogant or anything, but I felt it went perfect for me. I enjoyed it. It's stuff that I cook week in, week out. That's why I chose to do it, and yeah, I had a really good day, I think.
The starter I was quite pleased with. It was the prawns were nicely cooked, and the marinade that I used seemed to be liked by everybody, so I was quite pleased with that. The main, although simple, it was ribs with plank potatoes and veg. I was quite pleased with that. That all turned out right. It was lovely meat to use to start with. And unfortunately, the sweet was my disappointment of the day. I had that accident where I burnt the key ingredient and had to adapt it to a smaller portion. But I've had good comments about it, but I'm not happy with it at all. But there we are, these things happen.
Loved it, absolutely loved it. Lots of fun, not the perfect, as I was expecting, but really, really enjoyed it. It's an awful lot of fun. Starter, really pleased with the starter. Those burgers, the koftas came out beautifully. And yeah, maybe they're a little bit large perhaps, but our judges certainly seem to enjoy them, which was nice. And the little rustic farmhouse salad to with it is always a winner. Main course, the salmon was cooked perfectly, I think. Just pink in the middle, but nicely sealed on the outside. And the coffee sauce sits really well with it anyway. So pleased with that. Dessert, as you can see here. This is interesting. First time it's ever happened to me. But it's this odd culmination of, we think, or I think it's the sugar that's fallen through the mixture, and it's a bit like cinder toffee. Got nothing acrid in the taste at all. And anybody wants to write in and say, you know, why they think that's happened, we'd like to know. Quite curious. Hasn't affected the flavour at all though. So overall, I'm more than moderately pleased. But more importantly, I really enjoyed it, and enjoyed it with the rest of the guys as well.
Barbecuers, that's it. All five challenges have been completed. You have cooked us kebabs, you've cooked us fish, you've cooked us cakes, you've cooked us ribs, you've cooked us burgers, you've cooked us the lot. And I have to say, I've loved every meal. Well done.
Really.
For the grand finale though, you had the three-course meal, and we'll give you the feedback and say, course by course, who won each course. So we'll start with starters. Dan, I'm going to give you your feedback. You cooked us those prawns, and there was a lot of flavour going on in that smear. Wasn't it ketchup? It was like a glaze.
Yeah, it was the rub with some tomato sauce that was combined together and then smeared across.
You made me cry with the chili and the emotion, obviously, and it was delicious. Thank you.
Cool. Thank you,
Alan. I love that gin that you added to those prawns. What an amazing touch there. Love the presentation of it as well in the shell. I thought you really excelled yourself there, so well done.
Yeah, thank you.
Andrew, your pork burgers with the Bulgarian theme were amazing. They were really tasty, and the accompaniments you served with them complement them really well.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Three great starters, but of course only one person won the starter round. The winner is Andrew. Congratulations.
Well done.
But well done. Yeah. And well done.
Thank you.
So, straight on to the main course. And Dan, I'll again be feeding back to you. So, you gave us ribs. And I have to admit, when I saw the amount of sauce and glaze and flavourings going on, I thought it was going to be overload, and it wasn't. You'd cooked those ribs so beautifully tender. Beautiful accompaniments. I mean, the freshness of that salad, there was a bit of crunch on the potatoes, but the herbs and the spring onions, delicious. Brining sweet corn is a revelation to me, but I loved it. On the whole, absolutely stunning. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Alan, again, the ribs. They were cooked perfectly as well. They had a nice dry rub this time, and I really liked that. I liked the crispiness. It had a slight bark on the outside, and yet the meat still held together perfectly, so well done. It's really nice.
And Andrew, your salmon. For me, it was cooked to perfection. Really enjoyed it. The slight hint of ginger was lovely. And your char-grilled vegetables, again, a revelation. I have never had a cooked radish, and I will be in future. Thank
Fantastic.
You very much.
Great stuff. But again, only one person wins the main course round of our grand finale, and that winner is Dan. Congratulations.
Well done. Thank you very much. Cheers.
Well done.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Are we gonna
fantastic. Right. And now I can call you bakers and not get it wrong. Bakers, in our final round. For dessert, you each of us gave us a sweet finish. Dan, you gave us a very, very beautifully caramelised on the top apple cake. You'd fanned the apples on the top, the cinnamon underneath. It was a lovely, rich cake, but light. Well done, I really enjoyed it.
Thank you very much.
great clotted cream on the top.
Thank you.
Let's swing it.
Alan, after having a disaster of a start there with your pecans and inventing a new type of charcoal, you managed to salvage it well. You've presented a lovely piece, enjoyed every mouthful of it, so well done pulling back and getting back and serving us a nice dessert.
Thank you.
And Andrew, another apple and cinnamon cake. It had the potential of being a wonderful cake. I think the caramelisation on the bottom may have not been the greatest thing, but the flavour was there and it certainly was a nice light product, so well done. And the clotted cream was lovely too.
But again, three puds but only one winner. And the winner of the dessert round of our grand finale on the Great British BBQ Off is Dan.
Well done.
Thank you very much.
Well done.
Cheers, guys. Thank you for the clotted cream.
Without that, I wouldn't have been any good.
Thank you.
So, that's it. The scores are in. I don't know if you can do the mental arithmetic, but we now need to go away and add up the points. Each winning round has earned its winner 3 points. A second place won you second, and the third place 1 point. We're going to tot them all together, and then very shortly we'll be able to reveal to you who is the winner.
Okay.
See you shortly.
Thank you very much.
I won last episode's challenge, which was the breakfast. And also I got one on the previous, a shared win on the previous. So hopefully my points are racking up quite nicely. I don't quite know where I am. I'm not entirely sure the point system. I'm just here to cook and enjoy the food. So, I mean, great ingredients, great equipment from, I mean, ProQ have really done us proud. Big K, I mean, great. JL Butchers, fantastic produce. It's just been great. Been a really great experience, and whatever happens I'm happy with. I've had a really good time over the all of the episodes. It's been great.
I've had one or two things that I haven't been pleased with through the whole episodes, and I think the other two the chefs have barbecued brilliantly, so I think they've brought me a lot of knowledge of the way they're using their spices and ingredients.
So, have you enjoyed it?
I've enjoyed it immensely, and it's opened my eyes to these ProQ smokers, which are absolutely brilliant, and it's something that I should be looking more to do, I think.
Been tough competition. These boys know their onions and their charcoal, to say the least, and we've all cooked such diverse recipes and diverse plates of food that it's a tough one to call. I don't think possibly the best thing to say is I don't think I could have done any better, and what I've done, I'm very proud in what I've done, and that's the main thing.
So this is the moment you've been waiting for. You've slaved over many barbecues, kilos of charcoal have been burnt. On that note, I think we should thank our sponsors. The ProQ barbecue smoker has been a revelation.
Brilliant.
I think we all agree, absolutely superb. We'd also like to thank
JL Butchers for supplying all of our meat for all of the challenges.
Dornan's Fish and Chips
for the fish. Io Shen for supplying us with knives for the contestants to use. And I think that's it.
It's been a stupendous weekend. You've given us some amazing food. I look forward to the next one.
Me too.
But of course, somebody gets to take this home. So here it is, gents.
It's gorgeous.
It's not bad, is it? I think we should mention
Leo Forte, designer and maker of things.
Designer and maker of things. He's made a very beautiful thing here.
Yes, and
I think we probably all agree as well, Ben of BBQ Forte fame, that has created, designed, put together this whole competition. It's been stunning.
Thank you.
I've really enjoyed every minute.
Thanks for being a part of it all, guys.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
But who's going to take it home? So the winner of the Great British BBQ 2015 is Dan.
Well done.
Thank you very much. Well done. Thank you very much. Well done. Cheers.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
That is yours. Dan, everyone.
Over the moon, really, really, really pleased. So pleased. I mean, I may have said in the beginning of the episode that no matter what happens, I'm happy, but I'm absolutely over the moon to win. It's been fantastic. I feel there's been loads of ups and downs through the series, and it's been a really great series. I really enjoyed it. I mean, it's doing what I love doing, barbecuing. The other contestants have been fantastic. We've all got on really well as well, which has been great. Helped each other out at times. Like I said, there's been ups and downs, and yeah, it's been such a great competition. I've really enjoyed it. And to win, just the icing on the cake.